The radio button and the border are pink for the selected list item. This here is the default styling, blue button and gray border. The radio button is part of the input element, so we only refer to this input element, add the checked pseudo class to it, and change the accent color according to our needs. This is traditional CSS. The border is part of the list element though, so of the parent element. When using traditional CSS, changing the style of the parent depending on a descendant or a child required JavaScript. Using latest CSS allows us to apply the has selector to our parent, the list item in our case. With empty parentheses, nothing will change. We still don't have any color change for our border here. But inside our has selector, we can now define the condition that must be met to apply the style inside our curly braces to our parent. Adding the input element will make all our borders pink, as each list item here contains the input element. Adding only the checked input fields will give us the result we saw at the beginning. Has controls the styling of the parent it is applied to depending on its descendants. Browser support for the has pseudo selector is very good. With container queries, we can adjust the layout of a reusable component depending on the space available for a specific component on our website. This page uses the same component 4 times. For the featured course, we use a different layout than for the latest courses, as the featured course section provides more space for this reusable component. This example uses 2 sections, the featured course section and the recent courses section, with an equal structure. Each course card inside a section is wrapped by a course element. For the featured course, we only have 1 course card. For the latest courses, we have 3 individual course cards. With display flex on the courses class, we define the default layout for our course components, so each component should be rendered next to each other horizontally. Container queries are then enabled by adding the container type property on our course class, so the wrapper for our individual course components. By using a value of inline size, it is sufficient to only define a width for our container here. With this parameter, we can now run queries against this course element, and depending on the size of this container, we can adjust the layout of the elements inside this container. The addContainer syntax now allows us to refer to this container that we defined by adding a minWidth here. We set the value when these rules defined inside this container query should be active. Without using these container queries, the layout of all components would be equal, and therefore the additional space we have for the feature course would not be used appropriately. With container queries, reusable components adjusting their layout depending on the space available for an individual component can be created easily. Container queries are fully supported by all modern browsers. Using traditional CSS to apply specific styles to specific elements inside a container always meant repetition, so we have to refer to the container again and again and again before defining the style for the dedicated element. Nesting selectors was only possible with preprocessors like SAS. This changed as plain vanilla CSS now also supports nesting rules, making our code easier to maintain and easier to read. We simply nest the elements that we want to style inside our container element without having to repeat the underlying class of the container. Browser support is very good for the latest versions of the most popular browsers. The text wrap property controls how text is wrapped inside an element. With the newly introduced balance value for the text wrap property, CSS balances the number of characters on each line to avoid situations like this, where we have a single word in our subheader here, instead of having 2 words here, which balances the overall look of our subheader. Browser support for balance is very good, so you can use this value in your projects. Website elements are accessed via click, tab, or via keyboard navigation. Styling focused elements is important for user accessibility and for the overall user experience. With the focus pseudo class, we were able to apply our own individual styles to elements of our choice. Styles are applied to all elements where we use this pseudo class though, no matter if we select the element via mouse click or tab or via keyboard navigation. When focusing a button via keyboard navigation, highlighting makes a lot of sense. For a click or a tab, this isn't too reasonable. With the newly introduced Focus Visible class, this issue is fixed now. Focus Visible highlights elements when navigated via the tab key on the keyboard, but can distinguish between elements which shouldn't be highlighted when selected via mouse click or tab. So buttons are not highlighted, the input field here is. Browser compatibility of Focus Visible is very good, so you can use it in your projects.